Welcome once more to online video class for class 10th computer applications. Today we are going to study Java programs on series printing. In this session we will study what are the important tricks required for printing the series. Without the tricks, printing series will become very difficult for you. But if you know some tricks, then printing series will become very easy for you. So in this session we will discuss what are the tricks required for printing the series and how we can design the programs related on printing the series. So first we will discuss the important tips which are required for printing the series. First trick is we have to find out the logic behind the series. Sometimes the terms of the series are nearer to the squares or cubes of certain numbers. Nearer means sometimes by adding or sometimes by subtracting something in the squares or cubes of certain numbers, we can find the elements of the series. For example, suppose a series is given 0, 3, 8 and 15 and so on. To print the given series, first we need to find the logic behind this series. Only then we can design the program. So always try to find the relationship between the each term of the series and the loop variable I. For printing the number of terms of the series, we need a loop variable. Generally, we start the loop from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. And we control the loop with the variable I. So when I is 1, we are getting 0. When I is 2, we are getting 3. When I is 3, we are getting 8. And when I is 4, we are getting 15. So try to find out the relationship between 1 and 0, 2 and 3, 3 and 8, 4 and 15. So when I is 1, we are getting 0. So if we do the square of 1, 1 square is 1, and when we subtract 1 from 1 square, we can get 0. Similarly, for getting 3, when I is 2, that is second term of the series, 2 square minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, we can get 3. And when I is 3, we are getting third term of the series, that is 8. So 3 square minus 1, 9 minus 1, we can get 8. Similarly, when I is 4, we are getting 15. So 4 square minus 1, 16 minus 1, we can get 15. So we need to find the relationship between value of I and the terms of the series. That will help us to find the logic for this series. So in this example, you can see the logic behind printing the series is I square minus 1. Sometimes it can be nearer to a square, sometimes it can be nearer to cube. Sometimes we have to add 1, sometimes we need to subtract 1. Like this, we can find the series. But this trick will not work in every case. Second trick is, sometimes the given series can be a combination of two series. Like in this example, we have a combination of two series. 1 minus 3, 5 minus 7, 9 and minus 11. These are the terms of the series. There are some positive terms in this series and some negative terms in this series. If you see the positive terms, that is 1, 5 and 9. So 1, 5 and 9 makes one series. We can start the series with the value I equal to 1. Then next term is obtained by adding 4 in the previous term. So 1 plus 4 we will get 5. And next term 9 we can get after adding 4 in the previous term 5. So 1 plus 4 that is 5, 5 plus 4 that is 9. Like this we can get the first series. Now if you focus on the second series, that we can get by combining all the negative terms of the series. Minus 3, minus 7 and minus 11. So first term of second series starts with minus 3. If we subtract 4 from the first term, minus 3 minus 4, we can get second term of the series, that is minus 7. And subtracting 4 from the second term, minus 7 minus 4, we can get third term. So this is an example of combining two different series together to find the series. So in most of the cases, first two tricks will help you to find the logic behind printing the series. Now, third important tips for you, how we can print the given series. For printing the series, first we need to control the number of terms of the series using a loop. Generally we use I loop. Sometimes in the question it is given to print the series for n terms. Sometimes it is given to print first 10 terms of the series like this. So we need a loop variable that will control how many terms are required in the series. And in the body of the loop, we need to use this statement system.out.print in bracket general term plus in double quotes comma. Why system out print is used? Because we need to print all the terms of the series in one line. What is general term here? Like I have told, in first two points, we need to find the logic behind printing the series. So that logic we will write here in the general term. And add comma to separate the terms of the series. Now we will discuss the programs related with the printing series. First program here, question is given. Display the first n terms of the series 2, 5, 10 and 17. So first we need to find what is the logic behind the printing the series. We need to control the terms of the series with a variable, that is loop variable I. So how many times that loop will run? Since we need to print here n terms, so our loop will run n times. I equal to 1, I less than or equal to n, I plus plus. Value of n we will take from user. Now see the relationship between value of I and the terms of the series. When I is 1, we are getting first term, that is 2. When I is 2, we are getting second term, that is 5. When I is 3, we are getting 10. When I is 4, we are getting 17. So find the logic between I and the terms. So when I is 1, we are getting 2. That is 1 square plus 1, we will get 2. When I is 2, we are getting 5. That is 2 square plus 1. When I is 3, we are getting 10. That is 3 square plus 1. And when I is 4, we are getting 17, that is 4 square plus 1. So the general term involved in this particular example is I square plus 1. Now we will see the program. I have designed this program in my system. Since we need to print n terms of the series, accept the value of n from the user in the variable n. I will control the number of terms of the series. So first we need a loop variable to control n terms of the series. I equal to 1, I less than or equal to n, I plus plus. Now the logic behind this series, I square plus 1, that we will write in the print statement and separate the elements with comma. So when I is 1, suppose we need to print 5 terms of the series. When I is 1, 1 is less than or equal to 5, that is true. Then in the body we will get 1 square plus 1, that is 2. So we will get first term of the series, that is 2. When I will be 2, second time also loop will continue. So 2 square plus 1, that is 4 plus 1, we will get 5. Similarly, when I is 3, 3 square plus 1, we will get 10. Now see the result of this series. I have entered 8 here to find first 8 terms of the series. So when I is 1, we are getting 1 square plus 1, that is 2. When I is 2, 2 square plus 1, that is 5. When I is 3, 3 square plus 1, that is 10. Similarly, we will get all the terms of the series. Now we will see the second program. Display the first n terms of the series 3, 6, 12 and 24. So in this series, first we need to find what is the logic behind the terms. Relationship between value of I and the terms. So when I is 1, we are getting 3. When I is 2, we are getting 6. When I is 3, we are getting 12. When I is 4, we are getting 24. So if you see the relationship between the terms, you will understand that first term starts with 3. Second term is the 2 times the first term, that is 3 into 2, we will get 6, and third term is the 2 times of second term. 6 into 2 is 12 and 12 into 2 is 24. Since this is the series for n terms, so loop will remain same as the previous program. For printing, we can take any other variable. I have taken here I to control the loop and P for printing the numbers. Sometimes the elements of the series are related with the value of I, and sometimes to print the elements of the series we can take any other variable. Like here I have taken P for printing the terms and I is for controlling the loop. Now see the program here. I will control the number of terms of the series. So I equal to 1, I less than or equal to n, and I plus plus. And for printing the terms of the series, I have taken the variable p. There are multiple initialization here. I equal to 1 and p equal to 3. This is the first part of the loop initialization statement. I will control the loop and p will print the number of the series. Since first term is 3, so p is initialized with 3. Now what will be the next term? Next term is the product of the previous term. So update, I plus plus is for controlling the loop, and p equal to p into 2. So first time p is 3, so next time p equal to 3 into 2, we will get 6. And in the third term, p equal to 6 into 2, we will get 12. Then 12 into 2, we will get 24. That is the logic here. And we need to print value of p. Now see the result. First, we need to erase the elements of the previous program. Now we will see the result. Six I have entered. So first term is 3, second term 3 2 6, then 6 2 12, 12 2 24, 24 2 48, 48 2 96. I think it should be clear to you now. Let us clear that. Now we will discuss the third program of the series printing. Write a program to display first n terms of the series 0, 3, 8 and 15. So when I is 1, we are getting 0. When I is 2, we are getting 3. When I is 3, we are getting 8. When I is 4, we are getting 15. When I is 1, 1 square minus 1, we will get 0. When I is 2, 2 square minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, we will get 3. When I is 3, 3 square minus 1, that is 9 minus 1, we will get 8. And when I is 4, 4 square minus 1, we will get 16 minus 1, that is 15. So here the logic is very simple. Each term of the series is obtained with the logic I square minus 1. Now see the program. Zero, three, eight, and 15. So logic here is I square minus 1. And the loop is same as the previous two programs. When I is 1, we will get 1 square minus 1, that is 0. When I is 2, 2 square minus 1, we will get 3. When I is 3, 3 square minus 1, we will get 8. So like this, we can print the elements of the series. Now see the result. And I have entered. So when I is 1, 1 square minus 1, 0, 2 square minus 1, that is 3, 3 square minus 1, that is 9 minus 1, 8. Like this we can find the terms. When I is 10, that is the last term of the series, 10 square minus 1, 100 minus 1, we will get 99. When I is 9, 9 square minus 1, 81 minus 1, that is 80. I think this series should be clear to you now. So three programs we have discussed. In all the three programs, the elements of the series were related with the square of I. Now see the fourth program of the series printing. Write a program to display first n terms of the series 0, 1, 2, 3, 6 and I think it is 15 here. No, it is 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 6, 5. Sometimes you cannot find the elements of the series by doing the square of cube of certain numbers. So here it is a combination of two series. So if you don't find the terms related with the squares or cube, then try to find out whether it is a combination of two series. If you analyze the odd terms of the series, that is 0 here, 2 here and 6 here. 0, 2 and 6. 0, 2, 6 we can get by the logic I square minus I. When I is 1, 1 square minus 1 we can get 0. When I is 2, 2 square minus 2, that is 4 minus 2, we can get 2. And when I is 3, 3 square minus 3, 9 minus 3, that is 6. So first series, which involves the terms 0, 2 and 6, can be obtained with the logic I square minus I. Now if you see the even terms of the series, that is 1, 3 and 5. Even terms are straightforward, starting with the value 1. Then adding 2 we can get next term. 1 plus 2, that is 3, and 3 plus 2, that is 5. So this series is a combination of two different series. Now see the program. This program is slightly complicated as compared to first three programs because it is a combination of two different series. So whenever you have two different series involved, then we need to control the terms of the series. Which is the half of the value of n. Suppose the value of n we have taken from the user as 6, printing 6 terms of the series. Since this series is a combination of two different series, so we need to control the loop only 3 times, because every time we have to print 2 terms, one from the first series and second from the second series. So if we need to print 6 terms of the series, then our loop should run only 3 times, because every time we will get 2 terms. So 3 to 6. That is why to control the loop we need another variable. Declaration of variable here, I will control the loop. B is required for printing the second series, that is 1, 3 and 5. So first time we will store 1 in the variable b, and next time we will update it by 2. So we can get 135. That is very simple. But the complication is for the first series. So first series will be controlled with the variable I, and how many times the loop will run, that will be controlled by m. So m equal to n by 2. Suppose n we have taken 6, so 6 by 2 will become 3. Our loop will run only 3 times. Now the loop, first we need to control the loop. I equal to 1, I less than or equal to m. So if the value of n is 6, m will be 3 and I plus plus. So our loop will run 3 times. And b is initialized with 1, that is first term of second series. And b is updated by 2. So 1 plus 2 we will get 3, and 3 plus 2 we will get 5. And for printing the first series, logic is I square minus I. So if we have taken value of n as 6, m will be 3, and our loop will run 3 times, starting with 1, going up to 3, and I plus plus. And every time we need to print 2 series. First series is controlled by I square minus I, then comma is used to separate the terms, then b. B will control the second series, and again comma is used in the end. So first time when I is 1, b is 1. One is less than or equal to 3, that is true, then it will go into the body. 1 square minus 1, we will get 0, that is the first term of the series. And after that comma is used, then b. B is already 1. So first time we will get 0 comma 1, then again comma. So first two terms we have got. Then update, I will become 2 and b will become 3. Now 2 is less than or equal to 3, satisfied. So in the same line, 2 square minus 2, 4 minus 2, that is 2. We will get the third term. And value of b is 3. So 2 and 3 also we will get. So first 4 terms of the given series we have got. Now when I is 3, b will become 5. So 3 is less than or equal to 3, satisfied. So this time 3 square minus 3, that is 9 minus 3, we will get 6. And here 5. Then I will become 4 and b will become 7. 4 less than or equal to 3, loop will be over. So loop will run only 3 times and we will get 6 terms of the given series. Now one extra if condition is used. See whether this condition satisfies in this example or not. If n modulus 2 is not equal to 0, it means if the value of n is odd number, only then this body will run. So in our example, when value of n is 6, this highlighted line will not run. We have already got the first 6 terms of the series. But suppose we have entered n equal to 7, we need to print 7 terms of the series. In that case, 7 by 2 will also be 3. So m will store 3 and loop will run 3 times and we will get first 6 terms. Now one term is left. For that one term, this if condition will satisfy. If value of n is 7, 7 is an odd number. So whenever we have odd number of terms, then the last term will belong to first series always. And first series we have controlled with the logic I square minus I. So this time 4 square minus 4, we will get 16 minus 4, that is 12. Now see the result of this program. If we are entering 6 here, we can get 6 terms of the series, you can see here. One square minus 1, we will get 0. 2 square minus 2, we will get 2. 3 square minus 3, we will get 9 minus 3, that is 6. That is the first series. And the second series starts with 1, updated with 2. So 1, 3 and 5. So when we had entered n equal to 6, we had got 6 terms of the series. But in the same program, when we enter 7, now you can see we have got 7 terms of the series. First 6 terms are similar to the previous case, 7 terms. We have got 12 because I was 4 here. So 4 square minus 4, 16 minus 4, we will get 12. So 4 programs we have discussed. One more program we will see in the today's session. Write a program to display first n terms of the given series 1, minus 3, 5, minus 7 and 9. This program can be designed with two methods. If you analyze the positive terms of the series, that is 1, 5 and 9, we can get one series. Starting with 1 and after adding plus 4, we can get next term of the series. So 1 plus 4, that is 5, 5 plus 4, that is 9. If you analyze the negative terms of the series, that is minus 3 and minus 7. Second series starts with minus 3. And next term we can get after subtracting 4 from the previous term. So minus 3 minus 4 we will get minus 7 and minus 7 minus 4 we will get minus 11. That is the first logic. We can design or print two different series like in the previous question. And second method to solve this problem is forget about the negative terms. Analyze only the numbers given here. 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So if you leave the negative terms, you will get a very simple series. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Starting with 1 and after adding plus 2, we can get next term of the series, that is odd numbers, and we need to apply negative sign only when we have even terms, that is when We have second term, fourth term, and sixth term. Now see the program here. First, forget about the negative term, then we will get a simple series 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Accept the value of n from the user. I is loop variable that will control the number of terms of the series. So here loop is controlled by I equal to 1, I less than or equal to n, I plus plus. I is only required to control the elements of the term n times. And actually for printing the elements, I have taken one more variable a. First value is 1. So a is initialized with 1. And the next term is 2 more than the previous term. We have to print the odd numbers. So update for a is a equal to a plus 2. Now, at odd terms we need to print positive value and at even terms we need to print negative value. So for printing positive and negative, one more variable is taken, sign. Sign is initialized with 1, that is plus 1. Now see first time. I is 1, A is 1, 1 is less than or equal to n. Suppose value of I is 5, sorry, value of n is 5, so first time 1 is less than or equal to 5, satisfied. Now in the body, I have used curly braces because there are two statements in the body. So first we need to print a into sine. Value of a is 1 and value of sine is also 1. So 1 into 1 we will get 1. After that comma is used to separate the terms. So after printing first term, second time we need to print negative value. So variable sine is updated. Sin equal to sin into minus 1. So 1 into minus 1, it will become minus 1. Now sin will change to minus 1. When the body is over, then we will get update. I will become 2, A will become 3. Now 2 is less than or equal to n, satisfied. Now this time a is already updated to 3, so 3 into minus 1 we will get minus 3, that is the second term of the series. Then again comma is used. Now minus 1 into minus 1, again sign will become 1 because third term is positive. So update, I is 3 and A is 5. 3 is less than or equal to n, satisfied. So this time 5 into 1 we will get 5, that is the third term. And for the fourth term, 1 into minus 1, again sign will become minus 1 because fourth term is negative. Now we will see the result of this program. If we enter 6 here, so first 6 terms of the series, odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and 11, and the odd terms are positive, even terms are negative. I think this program should be clear to you now. That was the last program for today's session. So let us see a recap what we have done here. We have seen what is the trick required for printing the series. Three important points are required here for printing the series. And we had seen some programs. So please revise all the important tricks first and try to understand it. Then revise the programs that I have told you and try to solve the other programs that are related with printing the series. In the next video, we will discuss about how to find the sum of the series. So till then, take care. Thank you.